as I was telling Martha and sir as well that it's a very prestigious institute that you guys are having, and it's wonderful to be here. And what basically I would like to do is that interact with you guys as much as possible. And but before that, briefly, I'll just tell you a few of my experiences and whatever I think about media in general and whatever experiences I've had.
I come for a month to Mumbai, and I did my internship at Sunday Review and under Mrs. Bachi Karkaria, who's currently with Times of India as well. And there was a gentleman called Mr. Jerry Pinto, who basically was the main guy under whom I was just placed. And he was extremely, whatever I've learned from journalism, I think a lot, I think I will be credited to him. Because see, one thing is important, that it's not that how many people you talk to and how many lectures you have. Or what is important is that what you gain from what you are experiencing. And aapko ek choti si bhi baat aisi ho sakti hai that may stay in your mind, and if you have the vision maybe to understand it, that how important it can be. Something that Mr. Jerry Pinto told me was that if your first two paragraphs are very catchy and you're communicating in that, then those first two paragraphs should be able to hold a person for just completing your story. Now, that is something that I've always remembered. I've written for almost all the newspapers. I still do for Politikama, and in fact, a lot of people know me because of the videos and the interviews that I do with stars and other people. But what I personally like the most is writing the columns or articles or those interviews that we do in text or print. That is something that I personally still enjoy the most. That entire advice of Jerry Pinto, that your first two paragraphs are important, that I've always incorporated in my videos as well. Whatever features we do, whatever interviews I do, and whatever we do, I've always remembered that the intro, the first 30 seconds or 45 seconds of the videos, they've got to be like really catchy. One more thing that I personally incorporated a lot when I was growing up was something that I used to do, read newspaper a lot, and since a very, very early stage, and I used to write letters to the editor when I was in school and college. That is something, and 10 letters I used to send in Times of India or other newspapers, out of which one used to get published or whatever. If you write poetry, you should continue writing poetry. Don't think from this perspective that whether there's money in it or not. But if you have a flavor for writing anything, be it essays or short stories or anything, you should continue doing that. You should keep on honing that, because it will benefit you in some way or the other. Newspaper reading is something which is very, very crucial. At whatever stage you may be, wherever, say, if I'm traveling any part of India or any part of the world, I always make sure that I get newspapers from that place, because it's something that tells you a lot about that place. Editorials are important. You should always read editorials. You may find it boring at times. It may be about politics that may not interest you or anything of that sort, but still read it. Because editorials, they are nicely written. They are the pieces which have the best language. So always read newspapers, come what may. Try and read at least 3 or 4 newspapers a day if you want to get into media. And it's not necessary that you're getting only into journalism that you should read newspapers. Even if you want to make like documentaries or movies or anything of that sort, the more aware you are of whatever is happening around you, it will help you. In what way it will help you, I can't really pinpoint that, but it will surely help you. Recently, I attended a lecture a session on journalism at the Tata Literary Festival at Prithvi, where Mr. Rajiv Sarvesai was there and Srinivasan Jain was there. There was a lady from Washington Post was there. Now, one thing that Mr. Rajiv Sarvesai said that I think somewhere has stayed in my mind, because these days we put a lot of emphasis on this entire thing that aapko ek brand banna hai, that you have to become a brand. So there is absolutely no harm in that. That just if you want to become a brand, and one should aim for that. More important thing is that you should keep on trying to better your capabilities. You should always try to keep on just improving your whatever sort of media that you're aiming at, more than getting into the fact that how big a brand you become, more important is that how much are you improving on a daily basis, because that is what is going to decide how big a brand you are going to become anyways. It should not merely be judged by the fact that मैं अभी जर्नलिज्म में हूँ एंड दैट समवन हैज गॉन टू पीआर और समवन हैज गॉन टू मार्केटिंग और देयर अर्निंग मोर मनी देन मी फेयर एनफ दे मे बी अर्निंग मोर मनी देन यू एंड अर्निंग मनी इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर श्योर बट आई पर्सनली फील द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग स्पेशली इफ यू आर अ क्रिएटिव पर्सन इज दैट हाउ हैप्पी यू आर that whether you are doing something is it giving you happiness whether you're getting in the morning and are you happy about it are you looking forward to it that is something that no amount of money can buy for you I've interviewed Asha Bhosle ji several times and she's a wonderfully I think gifted lady apart from the fact that she's a wonderful singer she's also extremely positive in spite of whatever has happened in her life she's seen many ups and downs And this is something when I met her recently, and she said one thing which was extremely interesting was that each time I go before the mic, I consider that as my first song. That I have the same level of insecurity I have that I should not falter. That I have the same amount of questions for the music director and the lyricist. That how can I can make it the best song of my life or whatever of that sort. So that the fact that she considers each song as her first song has been the reason of her longevity. So that longevity has come only because of the fact that she has always tried to update herself, always tried to respect the profession that she is part of, and never taken it for granted. That personally, I have tried to incorporate that each interview that I do. It may be like with a Shah Rukh Khan or like a Mr. Bachchan or anyone else, or maybe like with a Nawazuddin Siddiqui as well. Or like even Piyush Mishra or Sanjay Mishra or any of these guys who are not like considered like big stars. But the idea is that each interview you have to give the same amount of importance because many a times what we see all around us that journalists they don't do any research. वो कोई एक फिल्म होती है वो दूसरी फिल्म के बारे में सवाल पूछते हैं दे टोटली एंड इट डजंट गिव अ गुड इंप्रेशन एट ऑल सो योर रिसर्च इज समथिंग दैट इज सैक्रोसैंक्ट यू शुड ऑलवेज डू एज मच रिसर्च इज पॉसिबल देर इज नो एंड टू रिसर्चिंग कीप ऑन जस्ट ट्राइंग टू जस्ट गूगलिंग स्टफ एंड फाइंडिंग आउट टॉकिंग टू पीपल दिलवाले देव हैड इंटरव्यूज इन दुबई देव हैड इंटरव्यूज इन यूके ऑल अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड दे हैव अ मार्केट नाउ एंड दे आर डूइंग इंटरव्यूज सो हाउ डज योर thing stands out the fact that if you can make it entertaining and the fact that they know that more and more people are going to be watching it and I think media is a wonderful field and there's a tremendous growth which is going to be coming in the near future already because of social media and various platforms there's a tremendous demand for it and if you can just enjoy yourself if you can just keep on trying to better yourself and the sky is the limit and generally just have a positive viewpoint and be as liberal in your outlook and just try and absorb as many viewpoints as possible from all across the world that will only help you that's about it
my name is geeta sharma I am studying a masters in communication and journalism I work as a scriptwriter as a freelance scriptwriter as well
what do you want to do after this
I would like to teach actually because I'm very interested in media so I want to pursue as a faculty and side by side want to get into digital media
fantastic
my name is Anmol I'm studying BA film television and new media productions here in DGMC
what do you want to do after this
get into film industry direction
you want to direct
Simona I'm doing my FI BMM right now
okay so what do you want to do after this
probably journalism
what sort of journalism
Crime,
Now I think it's a wide spectrum that we're seeing. Someone wants to get into journalism. Someone wants to get into movies as direction. Someone wants to get into advertising, and he wants to act, and she wants to get into crime and political journalism as well. And he has ambitions for sports, which is a wonderful thing as well. That it's a sports is a wonderful in terms of the amount of consumption that is there on various. Television platforms is huge actually all the time you have cricket and various things and now to kabaddi and everything is happening over there all right so thank you very much